always amazes me. Like, whoa, they are like damn, you know, passionate fans, that many passionate fans throughout the world. Just like, I'm just like so lucky to be able to have that many fans. At the same time, I don't wanna, you know, I mean, it's a kind of big pressure as well. As my Yoshiki classical tour, I just did 2 shows in America, 1 show in Mexico, 1 show in Moscow, and I just did a show in Berlin. So I wanna go beyond their expectation. Like, you know, if they are expecting, you know, 10, I wanna give them not 100, 1,000, or even, yeah, something unlimited amount of, like, you know, percentage. I mean, just, so that's a big pressure, but that kind of makes me very, you know, keeps me going, like, it makes me really excited, yeah.
Does it affect your creative process in any way, knowing that you are now reaching a completely global audience?
Great question. Yes and no. When I compose, it's like a very, how do you say, very sacred moment. So even though I think about, oh, this is going to be a great melody for the radio, great melody for blah, 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 but my last decision, this is going to be the song, is like, that touches my heart, or touch, that's, so, yeah, I, you know, definitely think about this song is going to be, you know, released worldwide, or English, more like English lyrics, or think about that, but at the end, I just say either beautiful song or not beautiful song. So that's, yeah.
What do you think music gives people, not just as creators, but as people who enjoy listening to music? Why is it such an important part of all of our lives?
I also study music therapy. So, you know, the music can improve the ability to people to do anything. Well, what happened was one of my, that's like my brother's daughter. That's my niece. Mm-hmm. Yeah, she had a heart surgery. So then my the doctor who did operation during the operation. He was listening my classical album. It's like, that's like very interesting. Very interesting. But anyway, that was a successful operation. Then I start thinking, like, how does music affect people's, you know, mind? Then some people say Mozart is good for your brain, blah, blah, blah. As far as I'm, you know, the result I'm studying, any music, like even rap or EDM or anything you like, if you're listening, that's gonna supposed to be enhance your, like, you know, ability or something like that. Anyway, that's another thing, but like, I lost my father when I was 10 years old, and then, you know, he committed suicide. So I was really depressed kid. Without music, I don't know if I could even survive. So it's a very, it's, you know, I don't think there's like a one simple answer why music is so important for everybody's lives. But to me, it's like almost like a more than life, you know, yeah. People need to eat to survive. People need to sleep to survive. Well, actually, I don't sleep, but but people need music. So I'm very glad I'm, you know, creating music for that reason. I think it's the main, most important thing of the music is the melody. So if you have like a really beautiful melody, that melody can, you know, go along with rock, heavy metal, hard rock, or even classical music, or electric dance music, or jazz. So to me, just when, you know, the music touches the heart, I think it's just touching the heart. It's not like a very defined place or anything. You know, of course, when you wake up, something, you want to listen to something heavy or something pop or something, you know, rap music or something like that. But whatever makes you feel good, you know, it's just, I really think about the melody is, you know. Yeah, of course, something simple. Record label always say, you know, the chorus needs to start less than a minute. then, you know, needs to have hook first 15 seconds. Like, I can do that, but so, you know, I mean, there's a song called Out of Life. That was once 30 minutes long song. Yeah, I was with Sony Record at that time. Then they kept telling me about radio. I said, great, I have a perfect song for you. That wrote that song. Well, no, that's not the only reason I wrote that song, but I the one that played the song, boom. They're like, how long is the song? 3 minutes, 3 minutes and a half? No, 30 minutes. Again, I'm very rebel against all those things, you know. I mean, also these days there's the internet and the YouTube and everything. So, I mean, the people say YouTube, people's attention, how do you say, attention spans 90 seconds. Might be true, but it depends on what kind of music, what kind of art, you know. So I think, you know, the music can be even 100 hours long or like 10 hours long. It's, yeah, I mean, that means it doesn't have to be simple. That can be super complicated, but still can be popular. Yeah, that's how I believe. You know, even our band, like 20 years ago, probably nobody knew us. Because of the internet, people started listening. Oh, like there's a band. We are strange look, looking. And then, oh, heavy music? Oh, we have a ballad? What kind of band is that? You know, people start finding out. I think it's great because of the internet. I think, you know, I think internet contribute a lot of part, a big part of that, you know, spreading the Japanese music bands, yeah, you know, like that. I grew up in Japan, you know, no matter how many Western music influenced me, but there's something in me, you know, like everyday life, you just absorb while you're listening. Like, again, like, you know, every time I turn on a TV in Japan, I was listening, I'm watching animation, that music just, you know, my body absorbed it. So it's just, also being in Japan, like, it's a lot of, like, you know, some Japanese instruments or Eastern music. So it's kind of mixed up in an interesting way. So there as an, yeah, we are, you know, even though we are trying to, I live in America and then doing a lot of English lyrics, song and everything. But I'm not trying to become somebody else. No, just trying to be me. Like I was, even Avan, we are trying to be ourselves. So, yeah, I don't think we have a problem like, how do you say, losing identity. We have very strong identity, yeah. Well, when I was asked to compose for theme song for the Japanese Emperor, 10 years anniversary, or Golden Globe Golden Globe Awards theme. But the moment I feel very proud of is every time I perform the show at the end, then the audience stand up and then, you know, start like waving and screaming and crying. Like, that was the best moment I'm always proud of. They are connecting with the audience.
Are there things you haven't done yet that you hope to explore? And do you have kind of concrete plans for where you'll be in 5 years, 10 years?
Yeah. When I think about 5 years, like I always think like, am I going to be alive? Alive, you know, because I don't know. I live like there's no tomorrow. They're like that. So I don't really think about that long. But, well, since I'm doing a classical tour, I go like, if you go this way, I'm going to go that way too. So I'm going to rock, super heavy. Like, you know, I'm going to rock really hard. Then probably I'm going to do classical like that. Just working with, you know, all those talented band members I'm so lucky to have all those members. But at the same time, sometimes it's to organize, because I'm the leader of the band, sometimes it's hard to organize all those members. It's such a pain in the ass. Oops. But you know, but it's really cool. But again, then you know, being just doing a solo as a kind of solo piano player, you know, touring, it's easy to make every single decision. I can make every single decision by myself. But sometimes I feel alone. So it's a kind of like a trade-off. Huh? So I love doing both, actually. Yeah, I think those, you know, a lot of drama creates band more interesting. Yeah, I wouldn't say interesting for our case, but, you know, we have tons of dramas, you know. Yeah, so. Well, I'd say thank you so, so, so much for being so supportive. So some people may know I'm doing a Yoshiki classical world tour right this moment. So if you have a chance or time, please come to see my show. Then, yeah, thank you very much.